is at least one lawmaker saying that out-of-control U.S. debt and the declining value of the U.S. dollar is convincing him to take a drastic step, one that has not been taken since the Civil War. Douglas Kennedy's live in the story in our newsroom here in New York. What's up, Douglas?
Yeah, Bill, the debt is getting bigger and the value of the dollar is getting smaller. It's a situation that has Bob Marshall wanting to take matters into his own hands.
I was elected in 1991.
Virginia State Rep Bob Marshall is so upset with the national debt and deficit, he says it's time for something radical.
You want the states to basically step in and protect themselves against a diminished dollar.
Well, our role as state legislators, if you read the Federalist Papers, is to protect the people. And if the federal government is not doing the job, we're the biggest institutions around to do it.
Marshall is now advocating the state of Virginia print its own currency to create what he calls competition with the U.S. dollar. It's a move that hasn't been done in this state since the Civil War. What do you hope to accomplish?
Well, what I hope to accomplish is to put the brakes on this train that's, you know, running away down the tracks.
And Marshall is not alone. 15 other states are or have recently considered proposals for alternative currencies. This constitutional expert calls the trend disturbing and possibly illegal.
The Constitution flatly prohibits states from issuing their own currency, whether in the form of coins or in the form of paper money.
Eric Friedman is from Hofstra Law School in New York. He predicts economic catastrophe if each state has a competing currency.
That would mean the destruction of the country.
Legal experts say not only is this unconstitutional, but it also could be devastating for the country as a whole economically.
I tell you what's more devastating for the country is a Weimar Republic-style inflation where you got to take a wheelbarrow to buy some bread.
Double-digit inflation, which Marshall says could be right around the corner. That's it from here. Bill, back to you.
Well, let's hope not, huh? Thank you, Douglas. Douglas Kennedy in our newsroom.